I mean, you know, the talent is out there right now, second to none. I mean, you know, I mean, they're so acrobatic, and I mean, they look like little video game characters and everything else. I mean, it is, you know, and you know, Sami Callihan's, you know, the thing is, wrestling for our generation, by our generation, so it's something like that. You know, and it's true. I mean, you know, it's a totally different. It's a new breed, for lack of a better term, because I was with a new breed a while back, but like the new breed now is it's geared towards that. I mean, it's suicidal death of instead of just having one Sabu, we've got 50 of them now. In a locker room. It takes some getting used to, especially I just was an old, I always liked the heavyweights. So, you know, when I see all these, guys that can flip and do all this crazy stuff, sometimes I have to step back and like take it all in, but then, watch it though, man, they're amazing at what they do. They really are. And I mean, the crowds are eating it up, stuff. But at the end of the day, sometimes I wonder just the longevity of them. It's how long are they going to be able to do that, and take such high risk and still, their bodies hold up. And, going back to which, it'd be a good guy to call, guys that are doing all this. Get a program with a guy like that can work around that and to strengthen up those ligaments and those joints and, everything else that you're going to end up needing, to maintain that craziness. Because, the unfortunate part is everybody's got a bump card, and you're only one bump away from being done. So if you can, strengthen up and do stuff to add some more life to that, man, it's the way to go.
Yeah, and if they want to talk about longevity, all they need to do is go find Billy Gunn, because I feel like it was 10 years ago that we were saying Billy Gunn looks like how he did 10 years before that, and now here we are 10 years later saying, man, Billy Gunn looks exactly like he did 10 years ago, and I think that Witch definitely played a big part in that. But before
you look at pictures of Billy when he first started, smoking guns and all that, and he's always been a big old boy, a big old athlete. But I mean, now, I mean, he's just insane looking. I mean, and I mean, he just keeps on and keeps on and keeps on and keeps on and keeps on. And I mean, that's the cool part about it. I mean, at 53 years old, that's what I want to look at. I'm 40 now. That means 13 more years I got to like maintain what I have right now, which I feel looks pretty good, but maintain it and make it even better, to look like that. I mean, and still be able to, bump and feed and do everything that you have to do. I mean, God, he's just so athletic, so fast. And I mean, watching the match this weekend with him with the Wrestle Revolver with Joey Ryan, man, it's just everything he does, he keeps a smile on his face. You just enjoy it. He just enjoys wrestling, and that's another thing is, I want to be that guy that I'm just out there to have fun anymore, And I mean, I think that's where it comes, several years ago, I made it a job and I hated it. And now, I just, everything's fun for me. I'm going to these shows and I just want to have fun. And I mean, and I'm impressed seeing these younger guys that are, they're coming up. I mean, we got a new crop of guys that are, may take wrestling back to where, DX NWO days again. Now, Monday Night Wars without the Monday Night Wars, because, I mean, 5-6 years ago, you go to independent shows with a name on it, and it might draw 200-300. Now you're going to independent shows, and they're, like this weekend, they're drawing, 2,000, 2,500, or more. I mean, that's unheard of for, just a a local independent. So, I mean, wrestling is on the move again, which is awesome.
I would say your lips to God's ears, but it's going to kind of play into my last question here before we get to the final plug for the Arabia Rumble. And that is, there's a guy who wears white who has made a little bit of a return. He redebuted back at WrestleCon, and now he's coming to AIW. And I think John and I are very happy to know that Mordecai will be returning. And I just got to ask you on the air here, how does it feel to don the white one more time and the Pale Rider ride again?
Oh, man, you know, the Pale Rider's been trapped up for a long time in me. And the Pale Rider was never really fully unleashed the way that it could have been. So, when the sky finally opens up on the AIW and he gets to ride down in all his glory, you know, a cross in hand and reap judgment on all the poor innocent souls named Hornswoggle that are in his way. Man, it's going to be like nothing other. The sins will be cleansed, per se.
Yeah, the return of Mordecai has been a buzz on social media. It's so cool to see, and obviously, for those who are going to be able to get to AIW, please go out and see Mordecai return and taking on Hornswoggle. I definitely think that is an interesting pairing, and little guy might be in for a big night.
Oh yeah, that's going to be a long way down crucifix style. I mean, he'll definitely be saying his prayers to the Almighty when he gets that high up. That's for damn sure.